Hi everyone, here's the video I was going to post about Pioneer's new App Radio 2 that I just installed into my Mazda 3. So you can see here from the main menu and also from the screen itself that it's a beautiful high-res screen. You've got some standard input buttons here, radio, iPod, apps, which I'll get to in a second, Pandora, phone for Bluetooth, and then if you swipe over you also have your settings and some other options there for the deck. So let me connect my iPhone 4S and I'll show you how this whole thing works. So you can see once you connect the phone that the apps button becomes available. So before you get going on your trip, you press the apps button. Right, it'll give you a warning on the screen as the app attempts to launch on your phone. Now, no secondary device can have full control over the iPhone. That's just something that Apple has implanted. So you just press allow here, and the App Radio app starts up on the screen. And then we accept the warning that we won't drive and operate the vehicle in an unsafe manner. And there we go. Now you are into the full advanced app mode of App Radio 2. So basically, what it is a deck that gives you control over the iPhone using the video out of the deck, and then you also have full control over the compatible apps. Now, more developers are making apps every day. These are just some of the ones that I have installed. So I'm going to take you through them one by one. The first off is Google Maps, which is one of the most popular map services in the world. You can see it right here. If I press the arrow, it'll take me and show me my exact location where I've pulled over to show you guys this demo. You can press the home button here, and then that takes you right back. You've also got photos, your ability to browse your photos on the on your phone while parked. So you can see, you can navigate right through the phone menu itself. And then let's say, I'll pull a picture of my puppy. So there she is. And then what's cool is you can also, because it's a capacitive touchscreen, do the pinch and zoom. So you can zoom in and zoom out. So again, just like operating an iPhone. And then pressing the home button here, much like the home button on an iPhone, takes you right back to the main screen. You can also go right into your calendar, see what events you have planned for today as well. As you see, I have the Chelsea Newcastle game highlighted, a game which they lost, but I'm not going to get into that now. So we'll come back out of the screen here, back out of here. Now the cool thing about this deck is that it will tell you what apps are compatible or when new updates come out. So you can see here are some of them right here. Car Media Play, Mixtrax, Extra Mile. It'll also tell you what you already have installed. Inrix Traffic, Motion Drive, Nav Free, and some other apps available in other parts of the world for navigation. Best Parking, RDO, and Streams, which are our music apps. So the deck will always keep you informed of what updates are out for the apps that you currently have, what apps are available that you don't have, so you're always in the know, so to speak, about what this deck can do. So let's get into some of the apps that I have installed. The first one is Car Media Play. This one's my favorite. This one gives you a really, really sharp, really beautiful, really crisp interface on how to navigate your iPod. So you can see it's playing here. Now, as some of you also may know, I have the 99RS installed in my glove box. Right, so I'm just using auxiliary out from here and then controlling the volume with my steering wheel controls. As you can see, it gets quieter and then it gets louder. So I'm running an extension cable from the steering wheel controller behind the deck into my glove box to control here. And then I also have my iPod Touch hooked up here directly to the 99RS when I want to go hardcore audiophile mode. So, and then you can see my Tweet and Midrange are installed there, but we can get to that later. So, let's get back to the deck. So now, for example, let's say I wanted to listen to another song from this album. I can just touch the album art and it slides right over, and I choose my next song and come back to the screen here. I also have full touch slide operation. You can see how smooth this operates, right? You can even do a little bit of like kind of scrubbing if you want there. And then you can also choose the next song there. And then you can also, if you press the magnifying glass up here, it'll bring up a menu just like the iPhone, right? And then you can quickly scroll through here. Or if you want to do an alphabet search, you can touch right there and then do it that way. Press W and then select your song to go from there. And then you have volume controls here on the side. Now, so here's another cool feature, a little bit of multitasking, so to speak. So you have your audio playing here. And now let's say I want to quickly jump to a map to do some navigating. Press the home button, come back out, touch my Google Maps, see where I am, go directions. Let's Google where the Rogers Center is. Right, and let's see, I don't know if I spelled that right. Yep, there it is right there. So, and then again, you can also, you can't pinch and zoom on this one. You can just use the zoom and zoom out button. So it'll show you where it is, and then you can start your directions that way. And then another cool thing as well, when you zoom in here, if you really want to get cool and show it off to your friends, you can go more and choose your satellite view. So now you have satellite view navigation, which I think is pretty cool. And then you can come back out of here, go back into your Car Media Play app, and say, I want to listen to another song. Now, if you have your steering wheel controls hooked up to the deck itself, they operate by track forward, track back as well. So that's pretty cool features in my opinion. And then you also can notice how crystal clear and high res the screen is. And again, just the simple, smooth operation of the deck itself. Again, you just touch it and it's extremely responsive. So let's go back out to the main screen. So my favorite app of this whole system is the Nav Free. This is my favorite navigation app. One, because it's free, and two, because the interface is unbelievably clear. So you can see I've got the 3D mode on here. I can switch to 2D, and this is incredibly accurate. And what also increases accuracy with this deck is the fact that it also uses an external GPS antenna, which I have mounted underneath the vent clips here. So let's say, for example, you want to navigate somewhere. You can just go into the menu, press navigate, go by address, and let's just say I want to go to Whitby. I'm going to enter in the house number. Done. Go search. Let's see if it finds it. There it is right there. And that'll find it, and then I'll route here. It'll calculate the route. And now it's going to start telling me where to go. You can subscribe to a turn-by-turn navigation voice, but I don't really use it myself, so it doesn't really bother me. And then you can go back in here, and I believe navigate, address, postal code. Here's some other options, preferences, right? Switch to day and night mode, volume level, sound on. You can save your location, you can do your points of interest. So it's a really, really cool, my favorite by far app. You can't do the pinch and zoom on this app, but here you go, you can zoom all the way out and you can see everything. And the coolest thing that's really, really important, I think, with this is that it's self-updating, and most importantly, it's free. So here now, for the price of the app radio and your iPhone 4S or 4 if you have that, you have a navigation in-dash system. It uses your data, but a lot of people have decent sized data plans, so it shouldn't eat up too much. And again, I want to go back out. I want my Car Media Play to come on, and I want to change another song. And I want to go back to my Nav Free. It'll take a second to boot up again. And here I am, I'm right back where I started. So those are the navigation and Car Media Play apps. So now I want to take you to another app called Mixtrax. Now what Mixtrax is a new pioneer technology that what it does is it automatically analyzes your library and creates a gapless DJ mix with a variety of effects. And it's all done for you automatically. There's nothing else you have to worry about. It takes care of everything all at once. Now I think There might be some work that it has to do on my library. Yep, you can see it doing it there on the bottom corner. Right, so if you've added new songs to your iTunes library, it will update for you when you plug it into the app radio. Now you can see it hasn't done my entire library, and the reason for that is because there's a PC application where you can upload your entire library to the Mixtrax server. And so let's say I update 1,000 songs, and let's say you update another 500 songs. There's 1,500 songs there now that the third person can come in and analyze. So the difference there of songs is because those songs are not in the iTunes server yet. Mixtrax server. So let's just say I want to listen to a beat mix. I select this, and it's going to quickly analyze the best place to start. So let me turn it up a little bit. I can scrub. So try and listen to the transition if you can. So you heard that little DJ effect that it went through and matched up perfectly into the best, fastest part of the next song. So what it does is it uses beats per minute and beat matches the next track to give you the best possible mix for whatever you feel like listening to. So let's say, for example, there's another song you want to listen to. Let's do this one. You can just jump right to this. You can see it's working its way to find the proper part. And there you go. And then you can also change the type of mix that you want. This is the short and fast mix. And then you can change it to the full song as well. So you can listen to the entire song, right? Or if you just want to listen to a shorter part and have a much faster mix, you can do it that way. And then just to give you again another example. It just mixes right in seamlessly. It's a fantastic app. If you're really like an amateur DJ or want to get into DJing, or if you just love DJ mixes, this will do your own DJ mix for you in your car. So you could be driving along to the club, getting amped up and getting ready to go, and this application will do it for you. So coming back in, there's another couple of apps here. Inrix is an app that's designed to use for traffic. I turned the location services off on this app, that's why. But what this app does is it gives you, let me quickly go, now here's an example. So I'm just gonna quickly go in and turn location services back on. Let's go to location services, we're just going to turn Inrix traffic back on. So now let's say, for example, you've come out, you've accidentally hit the home button, and you've got to go back to your app radio. Just go back in, press the app radio app. It's going to start. App radio starts back up. So I press Inrix again. It'll open up. It'll notice that I do have my location services turned on. So for example, if you wanted to click on incidents, right, if there are any, let's see what it comes up with. There might not be any. So it's telling you that tonight or this afternoon there was a baseball game. The Jays and the Rangers played and they won. There's road construction, different road construction sites. Just slide up. And again, look at the smooth operation of the deck. Left lane closed to different areas. You can press this one and it's going to bring it up for you on the map so you see the area that it's in. You can go back to incidents and then you can just go back to the map. It's powered by Google Maps. So, and here you go. There's your pinch and zoom. Let that load up for a second. Oh, I guess I jammed that one up. So that one didn't work out too well. But you guys get the idea. So it's on its way, but you can see where it's just got that wow factor. It's really, really cool. You can also make the app icons bigger if you'd like. And that is it for my new app Radio 2. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to post them. All right, thanks, bye.